Blackstone Audiobooks presents Penguin Island by Anatole France. Book 1, The Beginnings. Chapter 1, Life of Saint Mihiel. Mihiel, a scion of a royal family of Cambria, was sent in his ninth year to the Abbey of Yvernes, so that he might there study both sacred and profane learning. At the age of 14, he renounced his patrimony and took a vow to serve the Lord. His time was divided, according to the rule, between the singing of hymns, the study of grammar, and the meditation of eternal truths. A celestial perfume soon disclosed the virtues of the monk throughout the cloister, and when the blessed Gall, the abbot of Yvernes, departed from this world into the next, young Mihiel succeeded him in the government of the monastery. He established therein a school, an infirmary, a guest house, a forge, workshops of all kinds, and sheds for building ships, and he compelled the monks to till the lands in the neighbourhood. With his own hands he cultivated the garden of the abbey. He worked in metals, he instructed the novices, and his life was gently gliding along like a stream that reflects the heaven and fertilizes the fields. At the close of the day, this servant of God was accustomed to seat himself on the cliff, in the place that is today still called Saint Mihiel's chair. At his feet, the rocks bristling with green seaweed and tawny wrack seemed like black dragons as they faced the foam of the waves with their monstrous breasts. He watched the sun descending into the ocean like a red host, whose glorious blood gave a purple tone to the clouds and to the summits of the waves. And the holy man saw in this the image of the mystery of the cross, by which the divine blood has clothed the earth with a royal purple. In the offing, a line of dark blue marked the shores of the island of Gad, where St. Bridget, who had been given the veil by St. Malo, ruled over a convent of women. Now Bridget, knowing the merits of the venerable Mihiel, begged from him some work of his hands as a rich present. Mihiel cast a handbell of bronze for her, and when it was finished he blessed it and threw it into the sea. And the bell went ringing towards the coast of Gad, where St. Bridget, warned by the sound of the bell upon the waves, received it piously and carried it in solemn procession with singing of psalms into the chapel of the convent. Thus the holy Mihiel advanced from virtue to virtue. He had already passed through two-thirds of the way of life, and he hoped peacefully to reach his terrestrial end in the midst of his spiritual brethren, when he knew by a certain sign that the divine wisdom had decided otherwise, and that the Lord was calling him to less peaceful, but not less meritorious, labours. Chapter 2. The Apostolical Vocation of Saint Mihiel. One day as he walked in meditation to the furthest point of a tranquil beach, for which rocks jutting out into the sea formed a rugged dam, he saw a trough of stone which floated like a boat upon the waters. It was in a vessel similar to this that Saint Guirec, the great Saint Columba, and so many holy men from Scotland and from Ireland had gone forth to evangelize Armorica. More recently still, Saint Avoy, having come from England, ascended the river Oray in a mortar made of rose-coloured granite, into which children were afterwards placed in order to make them strong. St. Vuga passed from Hibernia to Cornwall on a rock, whose fragments, preserved at Penmarch, will cure of fever such pilgrims as place these splinters on their heads. St. Samson entered the Bay of St. Michael's Mount in a granite vessel, which will one day be called St. Samson's Basin. It is because of these facts that when he saw the stone trough, the holy Mihiel understood that the Lord intended him for the apostolate of the pagans, who still peopled the coast and the Breton Islands. He handed his ashen staff to the holy Budoc, thus investing him with the government of the monastery. Then, furnished with bread, a barrel of fresh water, and the book of the holy Gospels, he entered the stone trough which carried him gently to the island of Hoydic. This island is perpetually buffeted by the winds. In it, some poor men fished among the clefts of the rocks and laboriously cultivated vegetables.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.